One day, there was a knock on the door, and it was a tough-looking debt collector standing on my stoop right in my face. And we knew we had a problem. We realized, after doing a little bit of digging, that we had more than $100,000 of non-mortgage debt.
There were times that I would talk with other believers, and we would just share with each other that fear sometimes of giving of your first fruits or that tithe when you have all these bills that have to get paid. And it was hard to just kind of let go of that.
We had our faith, but at the same time, we were trying to do a lot on our own. And it was more of us doing it partly God's ways and partly our ways.
Yeah, I would say that there was some fear involved of letting go and trusting in the Lord for the right steps, for the best way to manage the money that was coming through our household. And we were kind of trying to stay in control of our circumstances sometimes, instead of allowing God to just kind of guide and direct us. So there were a lot of pressures building in the beginning of our financial journey. And I was experiencing depression, anxiety. We had some serious house repairs that we were dealing with. And we had a newborn. And it was a time of real fear and confusion and uncertainty.
I'll never forget. It was Melissa who looked at me while I was driving and said that we needed to really start giving it all to God. While it certainly wasn't fun going through a lot of what we went through, there was a lot of pain and there was a lot of growth. And growth is uncomfortable oftentimes, but the benefits of where we are now are staggering. Just personally, my faith has skyrocketed as a result of that journey. The truth that all that we have is not really ours anyway. It's all God's, and we've been blessed, and it's our responsibility now. So that tithe that we do regularly is just a reminder that it's not ours. For one, this pandemic alone, it should have been probably one of the hardest things for us financially, but God's ways are so much bigger, and we've been blessed more than ever.
A couple of things that God has shown us through this time of getting our finances in order has really been just peace in our family, in our household, and also just contentment in life, because He really is all that we need. He is more than enough for us.
We thought we knew what blessings were or what we wanted, and God showed us that what He has for us is so much bigger. We're excited about what He has in store for our family, and we're excited what He has in store for all of you.
What helped me tremendously to take that next step to start giving tithing was watching the work that God was already doing in my life. I mean, there was some real strongholds in my life, some real struggles of addiction in different areas. And as I started to turn to God for help, I mean, I felt like a child. I didn't want this in my life. I didn't know how I was gonna get out of my life, but I just kept turning to God. And every time I struggled, every time, whether it was temptation, whatever it was, and I would just look up at God and even just call His name, say, "Jesus, I need you." Literally, this thing would just start to dissipate off of me to the point that I was gaining ground, that I had victory, victory, victory. And I realized it's every time I trust in God wholeheartedly. Every time I cry out to Him wholeheartedly, I wasn't going to try to figure this thing out on my own like I normally did. If I had a problem, I'd call a mobster or some politician to come help me out. That was the old life. This was like, "God, I need you. I don't want to go to plan B. I'm going to plan A."
It's like anything else that you give God sacrificially, right? Your mind, your time, your money, your talent. It ends up becoming a blessing. Not only personally, but through our business, we were in debt. And it's like, how are we gonna do this? But it was obedience to God. And God says, "Test me in this." And I did. And we haven't stopped ever since.
I started to see some of the scriptures where David said to the Lord, "I recognize it wasn't the burnt offerings that you wanted, the bulls or the rams, it was me." We just started to see how things were getting paid for little at a time. We weren't stressing over that. We were more stressed on doing what was right. And as God would say, "Don't worry, these things will be added," it just started happening. like an abundance of money would come in an area we didn't think. It wasn't like we were going out there to get it. It kind of just came. It was just amazing how God was working, and we were able to trust Him, not looking for God to fill us with money, but at the same time just saying, God, help. I just wanted to do something, and that was the first thing I started doing. What we decided to do was serve, get involved in the church, to start giving that way with our time. It wasn't easy to put all the groups together or to actually work in the church or get involved in hospitality, whatever we were doing. But I knew it was one thing I can do is just thank God. Wherever He has work that needs to be done, I wanted to be involved that way.
As we started giving, I would look at our finances and look at the debt that we owed, and we faithfully gave, and it just didn't add up. I would look at our numbers and what we owed and what we had coming in. Somehow God just sustained us. So I think as we were going towards God and being faithful to Him, He was faithful to us. I know He saved our marriage. He saved our children. They're walking with the Lord now. And all the other blessings we've seen in between.
You know, the joy in our lives, the healing of our marriage, and watching our families watch us, God was holding us up.
Everyone's walk is different. So we had to trust Him with our finances, and everything changed once we did that.
What I realized is God doesn't need your money. He wants you and your trust. He wants you to put your full trust into Him.